Okay, so Arthur Terrence of India. So basically, this is an order in class insecta where grasshoppers belong to. Or like Arthur Terrence is a wide order which consists of grasshoppers, catydids, crickets, bush crickets, and so on. So basically, there are like 22 families from Arthur Terrence reported from India. So basically, I'm not going into much of the identification of orthopterans or grasshoppers today because it's just a 5-minute talk. And the major problem is that you don't have to look at the color of grasshoppers to actually identify them. You'll have to basically go to the genitalia of grasshoppers to get it identified exactly. So which is not so easy to do in a field basis. Basically, you'll have to collect it if you want to get it identified exactly to the species level. Maybe you can identify it to the genus level or maybe family level at the fields. So I'll just go into the generic details of it. So what are orthopterans? So orthoptera means ortho means straight and tera means wings. So these are basically straight winged insects. So it doesn't sound too good, I know that, because there are many insects which have straight wings, but it's just basically the meaning of Orthoptera. And like I said before, crickets, catydids, locusts, everyone belongs to Orthopterans. And basically, or conventionally, it is known as that Orthopterans consist of short-horn grasshoppers as well as long-horn grasshoppers. Orthoptera as a whole is not just grasshoppers, but it's known like that, which means short-horned grasshoppers as well as long-horned grasshoppers. So horn means the antenna of the grasshopper. So if it is like below 30 segments, it's called a short-horned grasshopper, and if it is like above 30 segments, it's called a long-horned grasshopper. So just two examples. What I've shown is like the oxyhyla and the Conocephalus maculatus is two examples I've shown over here. So these are the important characters. I mean, you can't say that these are the only important characters, but for the time being, I have to stick on to these two characters. So grasshoppers are generally identified with their long jumping legs, jumping hind legs, which you can see over there. I think it's not so, yeah, you can see at the right hand side of it. And some of the orthopterans are famous with their stridulations. Stridulations means they make some characteristic sound by rubbing their body parts. So there are many theories based on that. Like it is for attracting their mates, it is for catching their prey, etc., etc., many things. So, and like I said, again, the antenna based classification of short horned and long horned. And some of the important identifying characters are the mouth parts. It's very specific genus to genus, and the mandibles, it's specific to subgenus level, not beyond that. So this is the general anatomy. This is the simplest version of the general anatomy, and the important part which you have to focus on is the thorax, where the pronotum, the prosternum comes, and the hind legs as well as the forelegs. And the wings are also important, because the venation is quite important in the case of some families. So this is the generic metamorphosis. It's very simple. It is a nymph which gets developed directly into the adult. So this is the taxonomic tree that I was talking about, which means Orthoptera is generally divided into short-horned and long-horned grasshoppers, that is Calliferae and Ensiferae. And in Calliferae, there are 9 families reported from India, and there are in Ensiferae, there are like 13 families reported from India. And so this is the distribution. And here, when you see the figures, you can see that like 27,235 species have been reported all over the world till February 2016. But in India, you can see only like 1,200 species have been reported, with around 200 species conflicted. So, but considering the heterogeneity of India, we have came to a conclusion that at least more than 3,000 plus species could have been reported from India, but the thing is that we have only like around 1,000 species reported. So it is a potential area for taxonomists if they are interested in working with mysterious organisms. So these are some of the pictures of the Orthoptera of India page, which is going to be launched in India Biodiversity Portal shortly, and maybe in another 1 month or something we'll be launching that one. It will be having around 1,200 species and with stack shot images. I'll speak about stack shot images shortly. So these are the common families. So I can't go into like species specific, I'll just go into family specific. So these are, this is one of the most common and most studied family reported from India, that is Acritidae or shorthorn grasshoppers, or like you can call them true grasshoppers. So this is one of the examples, that's Oxia hyla. So basically, as color is not an important factor in grasshoppers, you can even identify them easily with museum specimens. So most of the pictures what I have is based on museum specimens. So, like some of the characters that they are having very less, I mean, they are having segment numbers less than 30, and their head is usually short and broad, and their eyes are placed on each sides, and mouth parts are developed for chewing, basically because they are herbivorous. The reason is that in the case of Orthopterans, there are organisms which are omnivorous also, and there are organisms which are cannibalistic also. Then, most of the Orthopterans are diurnal in nature, though there are many which are nocturnal in nature. I'll be talking about that later on. And Locusta migratoria is a very famous, I think so, that is the most famous grasshopper in the whole world, because this is the species which is responsible for the locust swarm, which has got considerable loss for crop and all over the world, I guess. So, and these are cosmopolitan in distribution, and these are a family which doesn't have much stridulatory activity, which means they don't make much sound. So this is this is the next common grasshoppers, that is the gaudy grasshoppers or Pyrgomorphidae. So in Pyrgomorphidae, it was actually classified under Acritidae till around 2002 or 3 something. The basic reason is that it is very similar in characters to the Acritids, but later on taxonomists, when the photography has developed, the microscopic abilities developed, they could find out that they look very similar to Acritids, but they are very stronger in nature, based on their antenna, based on their hind legs and their genital organs. So that's the reason why it was again changed into Pyrgomorphidae. And these are some of the characters, these are some of the details what you can see about it. And there are like around 440 species reported all over the world and 40 species from India. And this is one of the common Orthopteran which you can find in your house. This is known as Akita domesticus, or your common house cricket. So this come under the stridulatory families. So these are the families called Grillidae, or like true crickets. So in this picture you can see that how they actually make that noise. So they make their noise by actually rubbing their elytra. The particular sound what you can hear from your house at night. There are some of the characters also, like they have some cerci and the ovipositors. Basically, the reason why I'm not going much into the characters is that if I just go into the characters, you might feel everything is very similar. Because in the case of grasshoppers, they look very similar. But when you go to the genital organ, or when you go to the microscopic details, you can understand that these are totally different. Okay. So, this is an Orthoptera, which is nocturnal in habit. So, like, I'll just get you some sounds here. Just a minute. Maybe very common sounds. And these are the stridulatory sounds which you can hear. This is made by Akita domesticus. And the next one is about what's happening? Okay, So the next one is Grillo. I mean, sorry for not taking into that full screen. There is some issue with the sound to be done. That's the reason why I have gone into this mode. So the next is Grillo Talpidae. So these are known as mole crickets, or these are the crickets which lay under the soil most of the, throughout the year. So these are also known as burrowing crickets. So you can see that this is very similar to Grillidae, which is the true crickets. But the thing is that if you look into the forearms of it, I mean, or the four limbs of it, you can see that there is a burrowing character, or they have a particular kind of burrowing nature on their hands for burrow down into the earth. So these are also another herbivorous animals. So the sound that they produce is very similar to another phylum itself, actually. Here's another one. So, and this is longhorn grasshoppers. Conventionally, Tetigonidae was the only family which was considered, even though Encivira as a whole is called as long grasshoppers. Basically, Tetigonids is the only one which does really possess a longhorn grasshopper nature. So, it's almost the same details what is to be said. And this is one of the most cosmopolitanly distributed orthopteran. It is found in almost all parts of the world except permanently ice-capped areas. Maybe because it's not cold-tolerant species, basically. So, there are some more sounds available. Can I play it? Okay, fine. I'll just go to the images. So, the images what we have provided to IVP is this kind of images. So the importance with this kind of images is that we have done it through snapshot photography. So the thing is that how much ever you just go into it or like zoom into it, you can get each and every characters very specifically. So with this image itself, you might be able to actually identify species. So this is a representative of Acridiidae family, and I'll just show one or two more. So this is another family. This is another one. This is called the coffee locust. The Poikilosis pictus is also having almost. You can see most of the characters very distinct. The spines on the hind limbs, the segments on the antenna, everything can be seen very nice. Very specific, not nice, sorry. So, I'll just show one more image. So, this is another one. The leaf of this species is Dusertia japonica, and this is a Tetigonid. You can see that it has a very string-like antenna of the short, longhorn grasshopper. Okay, thank you.